Radio. I'm your host, Sean Anthony, on this Sunday, September 14th, 2014. Man, hey, let me ask you this question, guys. And I'll open up the phone lines early during this show because I'm just going to share some information with you guys and love to interact with you. But the NBA versus the NFL, who do you think? Who do you think has all of these charges, the NBA or the NFL? 36 have been accused of spousal abuse. 7 have been arrested for fraud. 19 have been accused of writing bad checks. 117 have directly or indirectly bankrupted at least 2 businesses. 3 have done time for assault. 71 cannot get a credit card due to bad credit. 14 have been arrested on drug-related charges. 8 have been arrested for shoplifting. 21 currently are defendants in lawsuits. And 84 have been arrested for drunk driving in the last year. Which organization do you think this is? The NBA or the NFL? And I would love to hear your response. And I'll give the answer later on this hour. NBA or the NFL? 1-877-300-7645. 877-300-7645 is a toll-free number to call in. We are worldwide on the web at gcnlive.com, streaming right now. Flowofwisdom.com is the website. You know, I'd love to hear your responses on that. The NFL or the NBA? Which one? That should be it. The answer is going to be very interesting. You know, throughout the week, as I was preparing for a show, I came across a documentary that someone suggested for me to watch. And in that documentary, they referenced a book entitled The Naked Communist. And inside this book, The Naked Communist, there's 45 communist goals. Now, this book was written some time ago, and just to let you guys know, I have not read this book, but this excerpt out of the book, I wanted to share with you guys on the show because I just think it's pertinent to and relative to today's current events and time, which we live in right now here in America. And throughout this show, I'm going to go through these and I want to see if you guys can see if this is still relevant. So I'll begin The Naked Communist, 45 Communist Goals. Not sure if I'll be able to get through all 45 throughout this show, but I would love to share as much as I possibly can with you all. I'll start with one. The U.S. should accept coexistence as the only alternative to atomic war. Let's see. Some of these here, you're going to be like, oh my goodness, this is so relevant to now. Like this one, for example, number 17. Get control of the schools. Use them as transmission belts for socialism and current communist propaganda. Soften the curriculum. Get control of teachers' associations. Put the party line in textbooks. 18. Gain control of all student newspapers. 19. Use student riots to foment public protests against programs or organizations that are under communist attack. Note, the success of these goals from a communist perspective is obvious. Is there any doubt this is so? Number 20. 45 communist goals. Listen to this. Infiltrate the press. Get control of book review assignments, editorial writing, policy-making positions. 21. Gain control of key positions in radio, TV, and motion pictures. Doesn't this stuff sound familiar? Doesn't this sound of repetitive information and words of encouragement and advice that we've been sharing here for quite some time? Doesn't that sound familiar to you? of course. 877-300-7645. This book was written in the 1960s. In the 1960s, ladies and gentlemen. And this the 45 communist goals. Gain control of all newspapers. Use student riots to foment public protests against programs and organizations. Infiltrate the press. Get control of the book review assignments. I remember a show several months ago, earlier this year, where I played an excerpt of Louis Farrakhan sharing a story of when he met with one of the popular actors back in the early 70s or what have you, or may have been the late 60s or 70s or whatever. And he was in the Bahamas or what have you, and he told Farrakhan at that time that they have this meeting, an annual meeting, all the top editors, the top screenwriters, the top authors, the top movie producers. They would meet in either New York or Los Angeles at this private meeting to analyze and break down the trends on what's going on in the country and what they needed to do to persuade the public in the United States to think a certain way. Number 17, it says get control of the schools. This sounds like Catherine Iserby wrote the book, The Deliberate Dumbing Down of America. Are we living in a communist country? The Naked Communist, the book was written, like I said, in the 60s by Cleon Skousen. And again, inside this book, 45 Communist Goals. Check this out. Grant recognition of Red China and admission of Red China to the UN. Note, not only did President Jimmy Carter fulfill this goal, but he also betrayed America's allies in Nicaragua, El Salvador, Iran, Afghanistan, and elsewhere. Number 10, allow all Soviet satellites individual representation in the UN. Number 12, resist any attempt to outlaw the Communist Party. Note, while the idea of banning any political party runs contrary to notions of American freedom and liberty, notions that are the exact opposite of those held by left-wing communists themselves, nevertheless, these goals sought to undermine the constitutional obligation of Congress to investigate subversion. The weakening of government's ability to conduct such investigations led to the attack of 9/11. I mean, some of these should just alarm you. The fact that this was written in the 60s. This was like a bestseller. It sold like over 1.5 million copies. And then it's finally found its way into the CIA, the FBI, and the White House, and in homes across America, overseas in Spanish. It's been translated in different languages. This is some pretty powerful information. But check this out, alarming. Number 35, discredit and eventually dismantle the FBI. Has that been done yet? Or is that soon to come? 36, infiltrate and gain control of more unions. They've already done that. Infiltrate and gain control of big businesses. Huh. Man, if big businesses, these large corporations ain't in the back pockets of these politicians and policymakers now, I don't know what is. Check this one out. All of this stuff ties into shows I've done in the past. Number 39, it says dominate the psychiatric profession and use mental health laws as a means of gaining coercive control over those who oppose the communist goals. Aren't they doing that now? Aren't they labeling our children, trying to label our kids with all of these mental disorders now and putting us on prescription drugs? And speaking of prescription drugs, boy, did I put out an article this week on flowofwisdom.com. Please check out that article, because the facts are alarming. The title of the article on flowofwisdom.com is entitled "Psychiatric Drugs Send 90,000 to Emergency Rooms Each Year." And my source sent this to me, this is my source for different guests that I have with dealing with mental health and prescription drugs and all of that. 90,000 are sent to the emergency room each year, or just on psychiatric drugs. I mean, when you read this article, the information is alarming. I'll break it down coming up after the commercial break. Again, I'll open up the lines toll free, 1-877-300-7645. Hit me on Twitter if you're listening, at Sean_Anthony. We'll take a quick break. I'll be right back. This is Flow of Wisdom Radio.